Hello and welcome to this latest episode of Rise of the Villa. I'm your host, Captain Berryman FM, and I welcome you. This is season 2020-2021 and season number 4 of this save. FC Villa find themselves in the Midland Football League still. And we've had a summer since last year, so obviously there's been lots of ins, but not as many outs as you would think. Let's have a quick look at the transfers. As you can see, not many outs, and those names don't really ring a bell, if I'm going to be completely honest with you. Matthias Robert is probably the only one that actually made it to the first team squad. He got on the bench a couple of times last season, but I was happy to let him go, to be honest. There's a lot of competition for that central midfield role, and he was never going to make it. So I wished him all the best and sent him on his way. But for our transfers that came in, obviously on the last episode we went a little bit kid crazy and a lot of youngsters have been signing as they've been going. Let's go for a few of the lads that have made an impact in the first team straight up. First one being Marty Waters, a defensive midfielder, Northern Ireland actual under 19. So very happy to bring him on board. He's going to be good. He's going to be very good. He's only 17 years old, though, at the moment. So he's struggling on the mental side of it. We did start him in the defensive midfield role. There's a sneak peek there to what the tactics looked like at the start of the year. So we went to more of a diamond formation. He sat there in that hole between the defence and midfield and was doing a pretty decent job. But form started to become a bit indifferent. And Waters was the one that had to be moved out onto the bench. But like I said, since playing with me, he has been picked up by Northern Ireland and hopefully he can progress with us as we go through the leagues. Just to prove that he's been with us for quite a while, he's been on our under-18s playing, well, he didn't play last season, but he did play the year before and the year before that as well. So, and he's been getting in quite enough this season for the first team. So welcome to the club, Marty. Antonio Hansen is a striker slash attacking right midfielder is his more main position, but we don't play that in our formation, so he is a striker. He's fast. Let's just say that everything else doesn't come off the page, basically. He doesn't scream quality. He just screams, get that ball over the top. I will beat any defender at this level, and I've got a chance of putting him back in there because I've got 6 finishing and 7 composure, so I'm not bad under pressure. A product of our youth system, he played one game this season for us. He started the very first game because of injuries around our centre forwards, as usual. He scored 2 goals, got 2 assists, and then he went and broke his foot. He got man of the match as well in that one as well. So he had an up and down debut, mostly ups, but then he's been out ever since with an injury. And yeah, I'm quite happy. I'm quite looking forward to bringing him back actually, because he really impressed me in that one game, and he could push. He could push, so just watch this space. Welcome to the club, Anton. An actual signing for us. We brought this guy in from Blackburn Rovers. He's a central defender, and his name is Perry Perry. His actual name is like Evans something, but I've nicknamed him Perry Perry because that's the only thing I could say when his actual name, let me show you on the information. His actual name is Evans Fury. Perry, 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 Perry. It makes sense in my mind. I don't care what anyone else thinks. Anyway, Perry Perry is our central defender. As I said, brought him in from Blackburn. He's doing very well so far. 7.6 as an average rating. And he fits the ball quite well. His physicals are still good, but they're in the low reds. So obviously he's still got quite a bit to develop that end. But his mentals are very good. And what he needs to be a central defender, he's pretty good as well. And he's also got something that we haven't got in the squad. And that's a very good free kick taking ability. So he's got 13 this level. Anything in yellow is very, very good. He's got an absolute screamer on the first game of the season. 30-yard free kick. Current ability, 4.5 star. Potential ability, 4.5 star and beyond. So he's playing above where he should be at this moment in time. And we've got him at centre-half and we could not be happier. So welcome to the club, Perry Perry. And last but not least, we needed to bring in some experience and a veteran because we've got too many young players and the defence was at the start of the season, well, mid-start of the season, we were starting to leak some goals. I'll show you in a minute when we go onto the schedule after this, but you'll understand why I've brought in a veteran. He's been there, he's got the T-shirt, John McComb. And funny enough, I actually know this person in real life. He actually comes from my area and played for my dad's football team. And I know that because he actually played up front and he can play striker if we need to be. Anyway, 3 games in the league, 1 goal, 7.47. He's actually retiring at the end of the season. And I've asked him to reconsider his retirement because he's come in and he's steadied the ship. And he's playing as a cover at the moment in the tactics. We don't need his acceleration or his pace, but we need his strength. We need his decision-making, his determination, he's off the ball. Everything that we need for a player to sit there at the centre-back and just do the job, just get rid of the ball. He's doing that very well. So welcome to the club, John. This is how we've been getting on this season. So Bybee and Wheatstone came first and we smashed them 5-0. And then we got a 3-0 against Bedworth. And I thought, hey, I hope this league's going to be quite easy this year. We could win it. And then that was followed up with a draw and then a win after extra time in the FA Cup preliminary round. And then we got our first defeat against Rugby. And then that was followed up with a draw against Ilkeston. Three wins in the cup, in three different cups, so the FA Cup and the Midland League Cup. Followed up with a 2-2 draw in the league. And I was thinking, well, we've only lost one, we've won two and we've drawn two. So it's not the worst start in the world. And then we followed that with a 4-3 win against Westfield, which was actually probably the best performance that I've ever had as a manager for this club. The reason being is we were down and out. If you just look over here, we got a man sent off after 42 minutes. Omar Castro. That might be the only time you ever see that player play. Reason being is that we had three players who were left back out injured and this young 17-year-old had to come in and fill the void. And he got sent off on his debut, so he probably won't ever play again. But thank goodness for George Burton, who got an hat-trick, and then Aaron Bentley. It was one of those games where it was 1-0 to us, 1-1, 2-0, 2-2, 3-0, 3-3. And then we got the winner, the decisive winner on the 90th minute with Aaron Bentley. I don't normally win games when we go 10 men down, and we showed some real strength in character to win there. But Westfield, who are not having a very good season, were bottom of the league. And it just shows how much we were struggling as well, because we only just scraped by them and they are very, very poor. We followed that up with a 2-0 defeat to Owl Church, which was... within the supporters, they were not happy with that, and it's been stated that they weren't happy. We followed that up with a 1-0 defeat in the FA Cup to Guiseley, and then a bit of a battering from Shepshed. They were 4-0 up and we scored two late goals, 70th and 72th, to make it 4-2, to make it a bit more respectable. And then a 3-1 University of Exeter win, and we changed the formation for that game, and I'll show you in a second, because we were going through this bad patch. And then a 7-0 against Westfield, that shows you how bad they are. We've got back to form with a hat-trick from Carl Johansson. And then we just played a game against Shifnil where Carl Johansson got four goals and we won 6-0. We were as low as 14th in the league and that's got us up to 9th. So the eagle-eye viewer would have noticed that this intro was recorded after the Leicester Road game. Yeah, I'm not going to show you the league. I'm not going to be able to show you the match preview or the starting 11. We're going to be able to go straight to the start of the game. Basically, I did record an intro, but I didn't turn on the mic. So we had to do the intro after. But before we do go to that, I'm going to show you just one other major piece of news that I didn't actually bring to you on the intro before. And that was Mr. George Burton. And why am I showing you Mr. George Burton? It's because Mr. George Burton has just created the first landmark for FC Villa of Aston. Well, first individual landmark. He's the first player to get 100 goals for the club. He did this in a game recently, and this is how it looked.
Can we break? It's Bentley over to Gillison. Gillison now. He's got Burton in the middle, but he's offside. Can he get back onside? He can. It's Burton to make it 3-2, and he has... Get in there, Georgie Burton, hat-trick, and his 100th goal.
100 goals for the club. I was super happy for him. He's a legend at this club. The status is with him. His name will be etched into the Villa history, into FC Villa. And I salute you, Mr. George Burton. But without further ado, let's go straight to the kickoff for Leicester Road versus FC Villa of Aston. Enjoy. We are underway and we are shooting from left to right. We're in our away kit today. Well, actually, we're in our third kit, like I've just said before. Here come Leicester Road. It's O'Brien and we clear it. And can we counterattack? It's Johansson. And this highlight is still going. It's Perry Perry at the back now and he pumps it forward. It's Birch. Yep. Here we go. Lindsay pumps in there. It's McComb with the header. And it's a fantastic header from John McComb. Boom. Lindsay with a free kick. McComb with a back stick. And what a header that is. 1-0 to the Villa. And that's his first goal for the club as well. So well done, John. That shoots us right up to sixth in the table. Here they come, though. It's Leicester Road. Bit of a derby, this, actually. Bit of a derby, I'd say. Bentley beats his man, though. And here we go. It's Chang Moon. It comes out to Burton. And we could be two here. Burton, can he cross it in? He goes himself. And that is a bit selfish. 30 minutes gone. 1-0 to the Villa still. Not much is happening, to be honest. Here we come again. I think this is it's Perry to Gatter. Gatter to Johansson. Johansson back to Gatter to Bentley. Poor pass from Aaron Bentley, though. And it's intercepted. And here comes McHale to Young. Big tackle, though, from Perry. And Dye picks it up. He gives it out to Birch. Birch will cross it in there, and it's easy for Geronimo. And we're a bit more assured at the back. We've been poor this season. Players like Werner and Mendes, who were our centre-halves last season, just had a very poor start. And here comes Berto to the front of the side. And here comes Chang Mu, and he's just scored a most ridiculous goal.
It comes out onto his left-hand side. Here comes Jaden Ali. I think the player boots it straight against him. Burton puts it in there. Defender, they had two attempts at it, and then whacked it straight against Chang Mu. 2-0.
Keep him out, though. Should be a goal. Oh, it's blocked around, and oh my god, what a terrible goal to concede as well.
Cross comes in from Birch, and they, oh my god, it's like pinball, and that's going a mile wide, and it's just bounced off and gone in. 2-1.
And that is the break, and it is 2-1. They did come back into it quite well as well. They weren't doing much, and then really finished the half quite strong. I'm going to encourage the players, though, and again, I'm going to jump in a bit calmly, though. Just going to say there's a lot more to come from them. Should we be beating teams like this? This should not be a problem. I want to go back out there. Still determined to get the result today and not to take their foot off the gas. It's Perry, and that's the end of that highlight. Perry with a free kick, pumps it in there. Lindsay wins the head, and it's Burton, and that is 3-1. Come on, boys. Come on.
Perry with a free kick. Lovely ball in. It's a lovely header down from Lindsay. And there's Burton, the assassin. 3-1.
Here we go. 56 minutes on the clock. And Leicester Road are coming forward with it. We're still on attacking. We've dropped down to 8th now. But we're on a good run at the minute because Johansson. It's Chang Mu. Can he get the ball into the box for Burton? He can. And that is 4-1. And this is getting easy, ladies and gents. Easy.
Calafa with the intercept, and that's it. It's basically 3-on-2 then. Don't know where the fullbacks are. They pushed on far too much. Chang Mu puts it in there. Burton with the header. Easy peasy. 4-1 to the Villa.
Just under half an hour to go, and we're looking pretty safe now. It's McCormick with the header, and he heads it over. He could have had his second today. Perry with those free kicks and those corners. He's whipping them in, and we are a danger every time we come forward. I am thinking about getting a few players off, though. 20 minutes to go. We're going to pause the game there. Go to tactics. Strikers. Johansson's on 6.9 and we're 4-1 up. So I'm going to get Gillison on. We're going to make him into, obviously, his defensive forward role. A couple of lads on a yellow card as well. What do we do with them? I think we get Musa on for Ben Calafa because he's young. And possibly get Swap. Bentley and Gatter around and get Vorbeck on this right hand side. Go with that for now. Because if Lindsay gets injured, it doesn't really matter because we can replace him. But the other two can't really replace them. I think that is probably that. I don't see these coming back at all. Can we get a fifth? No, it's a tackle by Calvin on Burton though. And it's a big tackle as well. They've got a chance here and he fires it over the bar. Time is counting down. 88th minute, couple of minutes to go, plus stoppage time, 3 minutes to go. And I think that'll be that. 25 seconds left. Shepshedder win 3-0. Are they the new Kwan this season? I think they could be. We're now on to 17 points and in 7th position, Shepshedder. Two games in front of us and on 31. So it's going to be a tough ask from us to get back up. But also what I am doing is I am enjoying this season. I'm enjoying some of the players getting some game time and becoming better players. And by that, we've just won by 4-1 against Leicester Road. An emphatic away win. Don't look at the shots. Don't look at the possession. We got more goals. We get the 3 points. And I am happy as Larry. Going to go in calmly. I'm going to say I'm pleased with your defensive efforts. I'm pleased with your midfield playmaking efforts, and I'm pleased with the strikers as well. And I'll hand a little bit over to Andy Reid to finish it off, and we'll end it with that. Forest win battle of Kenilworth Road. World news. I doubt that is world news worthy. So with that victory, that moves us up to 7th, a 4-1 emphatic victory over Leicester Road. They are sat still down in 14th. We push ourselves from 9th to 7th. Another couple of wins from us. We've got six points to catch up, basically. So 6 points, where would that leave us? We would be 23rd. So we would be around, if we played 12 games now, we would be 3rd. That's hoping that the other teams lose around us. So just keep winning. Just think about ourselves and we'll just see how we are when it comes to the business end of the season. I'm not promising anything this year. I really pushed it last year to try and get to the next level and it couldn't happen because of Quan. And I've got a feeling that Shepshed are in the same boat. So hopefully, hopefully next season we'll have a more even league where we can obviously hope that there isn't one team. I now know how certain teams feel in Scotland, I'm guessing, because they're never going to win the league every year because you've got Celtic there. And this is how I feel. We've got a Celtic in Shepshed and we had a Celtic in Quan last year who were just beating people. And when they lose, it's a miracle when they lose because they don't lose. So just looking at the schedule, we are in October at the moment. I'm going to come back in about 10 games time. While we've got these leagues basically where we're not going to kind of progress at the moment, but we're looking at players to progress as individuals, we'll try and get through these seasons so we can come back and do more episodes around certain leagues where we've got a chance of actually winning it, or actually just get into the upper leagues where we can actually try and get into a playoff system. So we don't actually have to win the league, we can get promoted via the playoffs. But I will be back, I think, around the beginning of December. So I'll be looking at more like the end of November. So Wolves Casuals, Highgate, Leicester Navarra, and then back round to the first games of the season once again. So I'm going to love you and leave you right there. Like I said before, I've been your host, Captain Beardyman FM. Do subscribe to my YouTube channel. Do follow me on Twitter, @CaptainBeardymanFM. And I will see you very shortly. Bye-bye.